James, you also named the England Performance Programme squad as well, which is going to be led by Andy Flower. The programme's going to be split into two, obviously the batters and the spin bowlers off to Sri Lanka and the bowlers off to South Africa. Why the split?
It's something that Kevin Shine likes to do for the best for the bowlers, take them off to Potchefstroom and work on their conditioning and their back-to-bowling programme. It's worked in the past. And again, a spin camp specifically in Sri Lanka makes sense with our you know, emerging young batters and our emerging spinners. David Parsons, Guy Jackson, all those teams at Loughborough put an excellent programme together and have done for a number of winters. And many of the England players that emerge over the last few years have come through that programme. So, you know, it's good that it continues. And we've got some good youngsters on that programme that will be challenging very soon for England positions in both one day and Test cricket. So we're very confident it'll be a good programme again.
Heavy Yorkshire presence, I just want to pick out a couple of guys. Adam Lyth, fantastic season.
Yeah, good season. That says Alex Lees. But Lyth's had good seasons before, but this year he's shown consistency and fully deserves his opportunity.
Adil Rashid as well, he's had another great season. What prompted his, sort of call back into this level?
Yeah, Adil's helped Yorkshire win the title. He's matured now. He's gained a lot of confidence. Of course, he's been in the England environment before a number of years ago. But as a point of difference, leg spinner, it's something we've got to encourage and got to look at for the future of cricket in both forms of the game.
And some new faces, Ansari, Billings, Riley and Wesley. So, some really good young players coming through.
Yeah, there's some really good young players coming through. And full credit to the county coaches that have helped them develop. All those guys you've mentioned are exciting prospects. And when we've got World Cup to look forward to, perhaps in longer term, in 4 years' time, or Champions Trophy in 2 years' time, I'm sure those guys will be putting their hands up and challenging for places.
And a couple of the quick bowlers who are sort of newish as well, Matt Dunn and Mark Footitt as well.
Yeah, Mark Footitt's been around a little bit, but again, he's shown consistency this year for Derby. And Dunn, of course, he's come from the England 19s not so long ago. And it's a reward for the sort of seasons they've had, so good luck to them.
I just want to finish with a question about Sam Robson. Tough summer, obviously hasn't been included in the performance programme. Is that significant at all?
No, Sam's going to have a break. Programme we've put together, and we're going to be choosing a Lions team for January and a little bit into February. But we won't choose that for a number of weeks, but Sam will definitely come into the consideration for that.